something on the list. Like what? What if you want to print a student of the class? Suppose you have class students. Students. Class. Okay. Is Ram, Gopi, Aditya, Kenu, not Ken, Kamal, Ashraf, Farhan, Arshi, Bilal, etc. Okay. Yes, these are the students. What if you want to print each student of the class? So you cannot print like students. Students class and class 0. Sorry, students class 0. Then students class 1. Then students class 2. It is a bad idea. So here the new method or new ideas comes. Here you can use looping technique. Now I will tell you what is loop. First let me write looping. Looping thorough list. Okay. So we can use for loop for that. So I will tell you how for loops work. Suppose for loops works in a similar way like this. For suppose I'm looking for I in range 1 to 4. Okay. Print I. Here I will explain you what is. Okay. Here 1 2 3. Let's see how what happens. Here for loop. This is the syntax of for loops. If you want to use for loops anywhere, you have to write in this way. First, I stores the value of the range. So, here range is a list. Suppose range 1 to 4. And let me convert into list. So, you can see 1 to 3. So, it is the list. What happens here is I stores the value of the list. First value, so loop works this. First I stores the value of a first item. So first item is here 1. That will print the value of I 1. Then loop again starts here, and here it takes the second item. Second item is 2, it prints 2. Then it takes third item, and third item is 3 and 3. And again it goes for 4 items, but it says that item should be less than 4. So here it only prints 1 2 3. That's how it's work. So you can use for loop for also for printing lists, like for. So this is the idea. For here the variable that holds the value, and here the list of items. It always take the list. So for suppose I want to take a student for students. STUDN for a student in class students. So students class, students class. Here what happens that students stores the value of each student. First student, then second, it stores the second student's value, then it third student's value, then it happens. Like suppose I want to print students, simply print students, or you can say that you can use also string method, like student. Suppose first student, so first student it is first student, student plus is a students of this class. what happens here is it loops through all the items in the list. So first, Ram is a student of this class, Gopi is a student of this class, Aditi is a student of this class, Kamal is a student of this class, Ashraf, and so on. So you can get the idea of how loops work. Let's not forget the syntax of the for loop. Suppose here a variable should be named that will hold the value of items in the list. Here you should insert a list, you should give a list method here, and you should never forget this colon, because if you forget this colon it will create errors. Okay, so you should always remember this one. And the one more thing here is, don't forget the space. It's called indentation. But if you will use any text editor, it will automatically create an indentation for that. Don't put it after loop. Suppose if you will print a backspace, enter a backspace. Sorry. Okay. If you print a backspace, it will go outside the loop. So it will not print. It will simply print. Or it will give some error. Suppose, let me run it again. Let's control C, control D, copy. We leave the same, and suppose you will write here this. It will show some error because the student is not inside the for loop, so it doesn't understand what is the student doing here. So it will show some error. Like suppose you can see another example here. Okay. It's a range 10 or 5. Okay. Let's play for I in range 5. Print. These are numbers. I'm giving some examples. These are numbers. How the for loop should work. So these are numbers. It will print these are numbers 5 times. It is great. It is printing 5 times. But what if you put these things? Oh, sorry. But if you will print outside the loop, so it will simply print only one time. Okay, here you can print number. See how it works. I is printing 5 times because it is inside the for loop, but these are numbers is printing only one time because it is outside the loop. So you should always consider the syntax of the loop and never forget the indentation, the colon, and the variable that holds the value. Okay. If you are too confused with the range, so range is a function or method which is used to print a series of numbers or used to create a list of series of a number. Okay, like suppose if you want, I will show you one list of range 50 or suppose range 20. It will build from 0 to 19. 0 to 19. This is the list. Simple. If you will print, okay. You can print from A to B, also from A to B. Like suppose A could be any numbers and B could be, suppose I want to print a number from 50 to 80, so it will print 50 to 80, up 50 to 29. If you want to print 80 also, if you want to include 80 also, so you can always use 81. That is the idea of using I plus, you will use I plus 1 later on. But suppose if you want to print 80 also, so 50 to 81. Here you can see it is 80. Then also give it increments, it automatically increments on by one value. 12 to 19, suppose. It will only incrementing one value each loop. But if you want to print by adding two values, so you can give an option here x equals 12 to 19, I want to print 2 by 2. So it will add plus 2. Here, if you want to print 0 to 50, okay, and if you want to add 4, so it will add 4 to every time, like 0 to 4 to 8. So you can also decrement the value. Suppose I want from 80 to 50, not 50 to 80. So I can say 80 to 50, okay, and with decrement of minus 1. 1829. You can see that's how it works. Suppose if you want 80 to 50, Python doesn't automatically indicate for minus 1. It can only increment automatically, but then decrement. Like if you will 80 to 50, it will not decrement. It will show you that it is empty list, because from 80 plus 1, 81, which is where condition false, that 81 is greater than 50, not less than 50. So it will not add a single item in the list. You can add 15 to, suppose I want to print 15 to 95 and I want to add each time 20. So simple, 15, 35, 35. Okay, these are the idea of range to create numbers. Now you must be wondering that you can easily add or subtract in the list, but what if you want to print the square of each number, or what if you print the cube of each number? So how can we do it? So we have to write logics for that. We will use for loops to print the square of the numbers. First one, I will take numbers as for num, and I want to print the square from 1 to 10. Okay. So we will use 11. Because I want to print 1 to 10. It will automatically add. So first it will 1, then 2, then 3. Okay. Now let's say here I is storing the value of rank, value of the item of the list. So first item will be 1. What if you want to print a square? Suppose square equal num star 2, and then we will print a square. Here you can see it is printing the square of each numbers. First number 1, then 4, then 9, then 16, then 25, then 39. Just how you can print the square of the numbers. You can say like, what if you want to print the cube of the number? Okay, so you can also print. Let me write. Okay, first let me write here the square of numbers. Here I want to print the Q of numbers. Okay. So let's say for Q of number, we don't have that column, that we will not use the square numbers. We will use the power function for that, which is the built-in function in Python. So let's say for num in range 1 to 11. Okay. Cube is equal to num u to power of num into 3. We will use the power method for that. So it will take the num, which is the first item, then it will power the 3 times. So we will print Q. See what happens. Here is first the value of the num is 1. Then it gives the value. It multiplies 3 times the value. So it will print 1*1*1, which is 1. Then the value incremented. First then print the cube, and then the value incremented. Now the value of num is 2. Then again cube value will be power of 2*2, or 2 multiplied 3 times. So 2*2*2. which is 8. Then it will print Q. The Q value is 8 now. It will print 8. Then again it will go after the, it will again start loop. And then it will do same for 3, 4, 5. Then 1. Then when the value of num will be 10. So it will multiply 3 times 10. It will get 1000. And the it will print 1000 by printing Q. Then the value of num will be incremented. And now the value of num is 11. So it will check. It will check whether 11 is less than 11, because number should be less than the B item index. Here you can see in range. Every I have already told you that it the value goes till the line. Value can go smaller than this, but not never greater than this. So 11 is not less than 11. So condition here is false. So it will simply exit the loop and not print anything. While working with numbers in the list, you can easily use some method to know the minimum items or maximum items of the list. Like suppose I want to create a list for numbers. Numbers equal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What if you want to know the minimum of those numbers? Okay, let's not make it serial wise, let's make it randomly. Okay, let's make it randomly. Update the value 11, okay, 2, 53, 44, 15, 56, 97, 58, 89. Okay, let's make it random value. Now what if you want to know the minimum of this number? So you can simply use these functions to know the minimum. Suppose I want to know the minimum, so we will write minimum numbers and it will show the minimum value. The minimum value is 2 here. If you want to know the maximum, you can do the same here, maximum numbers, and it will show that maximum item is the list. You can also get the sum easily. You don't have to write the sum. So you can easily find sum by using sum of numbers and there. You can also, what if you want to do sum by for loop? So you can get, also do this, do that by using for loop. Let's say for i in numbers. Okay, for I in numbers, let's say I value will be, let's say increment I is equal to, not say I, let's first you have to create another loop. So I, if you use I here, it will automatically update the value of I with these numbers. So the using I is not a good idea. So you should go for using another variable. Let's say sum. Sum is, let's say 0. For the first item, here is 0, and then we will update the let's first we have to create a value to store the number. Sum is equal to, let's say 0. Okay, sum is 0. Now we will update sum with adding each times the value of I. Okay, let's say sum is now 15, but we have not added anything. So let's say print. If you will print here, it will print each time the sum. So you have to print the sum outside really, because I want to print the sum single time. It is 15. So here you can, I will give you some explanation. What if you will use the same code here? Let's say to understand better. First, I'm updating the value. So if you will print here the sum, you can say print. It will print the single item. Suppose for I in numbers, first item is 11. So it will print 0 plus 11 is, it will print 11. Then second item is 2. Then it will update the value. Now the sum value is 11. 11 plus 2 will be 13. So now it will print 13. That's how it works. So you can simply write function for that. Right? Suppose print adding, and you can say which number I am adding. So you can get the value of I adding 11. Okay. Now it will adding, and now you will you can also see what it will print. So you can say print sum is for a single letter. Sum is sum. Okay. Now let's see how it works. And cannot int. Okay. You cannot. You have to convert integer into string, because integer cannot be printed with string. So you can use string sum. Okay. And see what happens here. Yes. First, it is adding 11, because first item in the list is 11. See, 11. Then second item is 2. So sum is 11. Then second item is 2. So now it is adding 2. Now sum is 11 plus 2. It is 13. Now the third item is 53. So it takes 53. Okay. So adding 53. So if you will add 53 plus 30, it will create 66. Now fourth item. Fourth item is 44. Then it will adding 44. Now sum is 119. See how sum the value of sum is updated. And at last, when all the value is updated, you can simply print the sum. So now the sum value is 450. So it will be printing 450. Okay. So let me tell you some trick. Like, if you want to print a single thing inside a loop, loop is used for doing multiple things inside the loop. You can do 1000 things inside the loop, and it will print 1000 things each time for how many times you want to print that loop. But if you want to do a single thing, for that you can use a list comprehension. That is a technique to write program more precisely. List comprehension. Here you can do the same task in a single line, in a single line of code. Like, in, let me tell you, you have seen that for printing a square, we have write this much. Or printing some, oh, it is for printing some. Let me show you where squares. For squares. Okay. Yeah. If you want to cube, or if you want to print a square, we have to write 3 lines for that. But here we can easily. Why it's not working? Okay. You can print a square using this method. Here, let me tell you how you can print. Let's say a square equal. We have to first take a variable that will hold the value. So let's say sq. First, you have to write the formula. So how we will convert a square? We will convert using sq star star 22. So then we have to write the loop. We can write for, so sq in, and we have to give the list. So let's in, right now let's say list is our 1 to 10. We want the square of 1 to 10. Here value has been stored. Let's print square. You can see how 1 4 13. That's how. If you want to print a cube, you can do simple. Let's say cubes equal. You can do the same for printing cube. Suppose first you have to write the formula for calculating cube, then the value of each CU. Here CU is checking. CU is using for variable. So you can say for CU in range, I want to print cube from 1 to 15. Then I will write 1 to 16 and will print. Okay, let me print. Here you can see. Let's say series. We want to print number from 1 to 100 in a single line. So you can do the same. Suppose an x will store the value. Then for x in range 1 to 101. Simple. Let's print series. 1 to 100. It's very simple. So this technique is called least comprehension. It reduces the code. You can use single line for printing the same value. Okay. Let's talk about slicing the list. Okay. Slicing means you cut the particular area in the list. But if you want the list from 19 to 98, only 8 elements in the list, or you want the list value from 5 to 6 items only, you don't want the entire list. So this method is used as slicing. Slicing, you have to give two variables. You have to specify the two values, where the starting, where you want to start, and where you want to finish the. Suppose let me give you my examples. Let's say the student says Ram, Shyam, Gopal, Sunny, Rajkumar, Tuddam, Atif, Rashid. Or you can add more. Let's say Adam, Adiba. Okay. These are the students. But if you want the list to print the name from Gopal to Rajkumar only, so this is called slicing. Let's say students here Gopal is indexed at 0 and 2 and Rajkumar is indexed at 4, so we want to print 2 to 5. Gopal, Sunny, Rajkumar. Simple. Or you can print, the thing is copied. First let me make a copy, then print. You can print variable from 4 to 8. Rajkumar, Shaddam, Atif, Rashid. Simple. And what? But if you want to print the entire from 1 to last, or from 2 to last, or from 3 to last, so if you don't specify the last value, second variable, then it will automatically understand that we have to print the first to last item. Let me make it clear by using method. If you remove it, if you don't put anything here, it will print the item from 4 to the last item. Here last item is Adiva, and 0 2 2 1 0 1 2 3 4, fourth item is Sunny, then it will print Sunny to Adiva. See, fourth item is not Sunny, fourth item is Rajkumar. 0 1 2 3 4, fourth item is Rajkumar, so it is printing Rajkumar to Adiva. If you can do the same for, let's say I want to print the 2 last item, where second item is Gopal, so then Gopal to Shani. But if you want to print the number from last item, if you will give it the -1, we have discussed previous, but I will describe here in detail. So if you will say student -1, then it will print the last item of the list. Here it is Adiba. If you want to print the last second item, you can say the -2. What if you want to print the last two items? So here you can say that we have to print -2 to 3. Here it is printing the last two items. You can see here. Let me tell you it. Here you can see last two item is Rashidan and Adiba, so it is printing Rashidan and Adiba. If you want to print the last three item, you can write -3, it will print the last three item. Oh, sorry, I forgot the column. So you can do this. Simple. If you want to print the last four items, simple, -4, and it will print the bottom. So
You can use looping technique with slicing to make it more clear or more beautiful. Let's say looping and slicing. Okay. Let me here. Looping will be, suppose I want to paint the first three students of my class. Then you can say for a student in students. Print here are the first three students of my class. Then print a student. Here it will print all the students. So here you can specify in list that I want to print the first three students. So then 0 to 3. All you can simply say, you will not specify here anything till print. It will know that it have to start at 0. You can do the same here as a, okay, sorry, you have to write the this code outside the class. Here are the first student of my class, Ram Shyam Gopal. You can see Ram Shyam Gopal are the first student. Ram Shyam Gopal, where is the list? Well, let's call it here, simple. You can see, let me show you, Ram Shyam Gopal are the first student of a student. So it is printing first year student. Okay, remember, if you can do the same by, if you will provide 0 to 3 or column 3, it will do the same thing. Let's print, let's copy and paste here. Let's specify 0 here. 0, it will do the same, because if you don't put anything here, it starts with 0. If you don't put anything here, it will go to the last. Okay, suppose you can check here. Here are the students of, here are the, wait, here are the students of my class. Okay, here you can remove here anything 0 to the last, and it will print 0 to last at anyway.
What if you want to copy a list? So you can use copying a list. Okay, you can copy the list by using equal. I will show you. Let me first make a new list. Let's say Indian players. Let's say Indian players are Hardik, okay, Sachin, Dhoni, Bhuvneshwar, Vijay, Rohit Sharma, and let's say Sami. Okay, let me make a new list. Let's say my favorite player is Indian players. My favorite player is all Indian players. Let's say my friend favorite player. Let's say my friend favorite player is Indian
and n plus let's say 4 to 0 1 1 2 1 to 5. That's my 1 to 5 player and my friend. So here you can see my favorite player is copying the Indian player. So Indian players list has been copied to my favorite player. I can print to show you that it is whether to check it is copied or not. My favorite player is, see, it is the same as Indian player. Let's call Indian players. Both are same. If you will print my friend player, my friend favorite player is, yes. That's how is copying a list works. You can copy a list of the list. Let's say if you want to, you can add letter. Let's say I want to remove my favorite player. I want to remove Sachin from my favorite player. Okay, so I can say, sorry, Control C, Control V. I want to remove Sachin. I will use pop for that. Let's say Sachin is the first. Then it will do Sachin. Now my favorite player is Hardik Dhoni, Bhuvneshwar. Sachin has been removed. You can add, and you can add Sachin in my favorite. Let's add Sachin in my favorite friend player. Let's say my favorite friend player dot add, oh sorry, dot append Sachin. Let's call my friend player. Sachin Dhoni Bhuvneshwar Prithvi Sachin. Simple. They have two Sachin. Not a problem. Sachin was already his favorite, but I had one more Sachin. So now Sachin is also again his favorite. That's how copying a list works. So these are all the list. But what if you want to make a list that doesn't change? Its value cannot be changed. Sometimes you want a list that this value should not be changed. It is tuple. Now let's talk about tuple. What is tuple? In the list, you can change the value of the item. In the list, you have seen that you can easily change the value. Suppose I want to change the second name, you can easily change the second item, such into any other thing. But here you cannot, but in tuple you cannot change. In tuple you can't change the existing value. Okay, it is immutable. Let me show you an example. Like, let's say we both make a list and let's make a tuple. My favorite food list. Okay, let's say my favorite food is say pizza. Okay, biryani, chicken popcorn, let's say coffee, and let's say ice cream. Okay, let's copy it. Let's say my favorite food tuple is tuple
in the tuple you use brackets. Okay, you can see I'm using bracket. It shows, let me here, these brackets shows it is a list. Why it indicates that it is a tuple. Okay, so here we have created both my favorite food list, my favorite food as a list, and my favorite tuple as a tuple. Let's say I don't like biryani. Suppose after some time I don't like biryani and I want to change biryani. So you can say my favorite list. My favorite list. Biryani is the first item. Then you will 0 and 1. So biryani is the first item. Let's say biryani to. Let's change biryani to kebab. Kebab. Okay. Let's print my favorite food list, and you can see biryani has been replaced by kebab. But if you will change in tuple, it will show you error. Let's say I want to change biryani in tuple. Let's say first item and change it to kebab. See, tuple object does not support the item assignment, so you can change. That's the difference between tuples and list. In the tuple you can change the value once it is defined or it is created, but in list you can easily create the value. So at some times if you want to create something that you don't want that list should be changed, you can use tuples for that. All operations are same, but simply you can change the value. But at sometimes you want to change your list, so you can easily update the value, update the variable that holds the items, that holds these items. So if you want to change the tuple, you have to change the entire tuple. It's my favorite food tuple is, have to create a new tuple, so it will only change the value. Let's say my favorite food is pizza, and let's say biryani. Now if you will print my favorite food, it will say pizza and biryani because you have updated the favorite food tuple, but you can't change the value. So that's the difference. You can use the operations as defined below. You can use for loop. Suppose I want to print my food, my favorite food. So let's say for food, for food in my favorite food tuple. Okay, I want to print my favorite food is my favorite food. Food is just the food. Okay. My favorite food is pizza. My favorite food is biryani. Simple. Can add full list up. Good. My favorite food is pizza. Okay. You can use any operation. You can know the length of your tuple. You can get the minimum from the tuple. You can get the maximum from the tuple. You cannot use sort method in tuple. Let's say dot sort.
will show you error. But if you want to sort in the list, you can easily dot sort. Field list is not defined. It's my favorite field list. Okay. Let's sort this and let's fit into this. See? You can easily sort, but you can sort the tuple. Okay? But you can use temporarily sorted. Suppose let's say print sorted my favorite tuple and it will work. See? You can use sorted to temporarily sort the tuple, but you cannot change the item. So you cannot change the index of the item, so you cannot use sorted method, but you can use sorted for that to sort the tuple. Okay, I think that's enough for this video. We will see you in the next video. Thank you. Ta-da.